great loss for Zimbabwe to start with. But for Namibia, SADC, all over Africa, he was an ardent Pan-Africanist, committed revolutionary, who sacrificed his life to free his country. I didn't stop there. We of SWAPO have special recollection about the role he played. One of us appointed as a director of elections. We were sent to Zimbabwe, to him, to be coach on how to go and run the elections. And he assigned current President Mnangagwa for 2 weeks to be with us. So President Mugabe was a revolutionary. Actually, he also rescued Namibia's independence process because things were not going right. And he wrote a letter to Secretary General, demanded that there should be an African appointed as deputy of President Atisari. So that process maybe helped us to achieve our independence. Besides that, President Mugabe was a spokesperson for revolutionary Africans. On the land issue, we don't express ourselves as President Mugabe expressed himself. We feel the same way, but we don't express ourselves that way. So that he told us, Zimbabwe belongs to Zimbabwe. Blair, keep your England. That's the way. People shouldn't come from outside and try to dictate to us. They must be partners with us. So President Mugabe was indeed one of those extraordinary personalities I talk about, the founding fathers who told us to get up and fight for our freedom. Sometimes you are oppressed but you don't feel it, but some people come and say, get up, and Mugabe did that. He didn't want to just stop there. He came to Namibia and also continued to support others. So it's a great loss. We expected it. We knew he fought his, he raised his race very well. He fought a brave battle. Now is the time for him to say goodbye. 95 years is yes, not to cry, but to celebrate. He had a illustrious life, a brilliant intellectual, and even those who hated him would like to listen to him. When he was speaking at AU or at the United Nations, the hall is packed, and that's the type of a person. All great leaders are controversial. Yes, he was controversial, and therefore we must also learn, those of us who are now third wave of presidents, that overstaying is not good. That's why I believe strongly in term limit, and that's why we, a third wave African leaders, are not extraordinary personalities. But for them, for founding fathers, they deserve that honor.
So how can now the third wave leaders, in which you are also in, carry on the torch, that of economic struggle that seems to have taken its lessons from how President Mugabe and others fought independent the political struggle of the region?
Yes, but we don't say we're agreeing with his all his economic policies. He himself warned us about land. We did it because in our case, we had to do that, but be careful. So situations differ, but we learn from him to be patriotic. We have to address our situation in the confines of our own realities. So we are approaching our land issues separately, differently from them, but we learn lessons. That land is very important. We are therefore appealing to our brothers and sisters who have to own land. We keep on saying only peace we can have is when prosperity is shared. We must know in Namibia white, black, yellow. It's my statement I will keep on saying until maybe I go one day. If Namibians don't come together and share land, economic, whatever it is, we're not going to be a peaceful country forever. So President Mugabe played his role. Of course, by staying too long, there were no problems. That's why we think we must stay and move at appropriate time, so that full honor could be bestowed upon us, as we deserve it. But still, it doesn't take away from his great role he played internationally, in Africa, and in liberation movements, frontline states. So may his soul rest in eternal peace.